What happens to a soldier happens to a nation. Since 2008, the Telling Project has helped hundreds of veterans and their families tell and perform their stories in an effort to raise awareness and to bridge the gap between civilians and military in a time of war.
Estimated
troops and veterans are reporting sexual assault and harassment at an accelerating rate, a 39% increase since 2011.
I was raped during military service and during my first assignment. That was 1988. I was 18 years old.
And the nation is at last focusing much needed attention on this situation so long neglected. In November, a new Telling Project performance entitled Uniform Code will bring a group of military sexual trauma survivors and their families to Washington, D.C. from across the nation to tell their stories. Hosted by the Veterans History Project of the Library of Congress, Uniform Code will premiere at Coolidge Auditorium, a forum created by Congress for ideas and artists of importance to the American people. Between now and November, the Telling Project will be working intensively with the cast of Uniform Code. We will be interviewing them about their experiences.
Because nobody got it. Nobody understood.
Here would be a great one. Nobody got it, one knee. Nobody understood. Nobody understood, the other knee.
Teaching them the basics of stagecraft, rehearsing them to performance readiness, and supporting their efforts with a comprehensive press and promotional campaign to make sure they are heard.
Was able to liberate concentration camps? That is an amazing thing.
After the emotions we just experienced, there is no eloquence that can match the stories we've just been told. Contrary to all indications, there is no great gap in love, affection, support, or admiration between Americans and those who have served their nation in uniform. What there is from time to time is a gap of knowledge. So where do we go from here?
You will make this happen. Please support Uniform Code. Because what happens to a soldier happens to a nation.